When you first get a spinal cord injury, there's a thing you experience called spinal shock. This is just a note to say that I'm not a healthcare professional, just a girl with a spinal cord injury sharing what I've learned. So when you first get injured, you experience something called spinal shock. It can last from a few days to a few weeks to a few months. The average time it lasts is 4 to 12 weeks. The thing you need to remember is it's not permanent, it's only temporary. What it is what the name says it is. Basically, your spinal cord goes into a state of shock, and the automatic reflexes and messages that usually occur temporarily stop working. Everyone gets some degree of spinal shock, and everyone's different. Usually, it is more severe if your spinal cord is completely severed or if it's extremely swollen. So what's happening is after the injury, the spinal cord enters either hyperreflexia, a significant reduction in reflexes, or areflexia, the temporary loss of reflexes. I can't stress enough that everyone is different, and it is often not until you come out of spinal shock that you can notice the effect it is at. The parts in your body that may be affected is your bladder, your bowel, your control of sweating, or your sexual function. For example, some people might notice a big change in their bladder. So when you're in spinal shock, you might be able to hold large amounts of urine. That's because your reflex in your bladder isn't working to release when you're full. And then when you get out of spinal shock, you start leaking when you had those same large amounts. That's because your reflexes are working again. Spasticity is something that may occur more strongly once you're out of spinal shock, because when you're first injured, below your level of injury, your muscles are weak and more flexible because your reflexes are absent. But once you're out of spinal shock, your reflexes become more active. So then you might get spasms. Something that also happens is the swelling in the spinal cord reduces, so nerves start to regain some of their function. This might mean more sensation or mobility after spinal shock. However, this does not occur for everyone, as everybody's injuries are different. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope it helped you understand spinal shock a little bit better. Remember to check out my other videos I made in the Spinal Cord Injury Rehab series. I'll put the link in the description below. Click that thumbs up button if you found this interesting, and remember to subscribe.